Today's video about why beekeepers live longer in average and about bee products for healthier life. My channel subscribers probably know that I keep honeybees in Taiwan. This is the Asian honeybees Apis serrana. Please watch my old videos for details. I give the references also in the description. Part of my motivation was from the beginning to extend my lifespan and to improve my health. As it is well known that beekeepers live in average much longer than people in other professions. It can be explained by a number of factors. The beekeepers spend a lot of time away from big cities, roads, that is away from noise, stress, water and air pollution. Beekeeping involves physical activity, also not very intensive, not every day, but yet it is very helpful. Beekeepers enjoy their profession. Bees are wonderful and actually very intelligent creatures. It is a pleasure to take care of them. The duties of the beekeeper include inspecting the hives approximately every week to remove the queen cells containing royal jelly. What I personally do with the queen cells, I eat them. Why not? Royal jelly is a superfood which increases the lifespan of a queen bee by 40 times compared to that of a working bee. Royal jelly improves health and possibly prolongs human life. Also, the beekeeper must remove the drone brood. It can also be considered a superfood and a valuable source of protein. The consumption of bee larvae is very common in Southeast Asia. It is both a delicacy and a medicine. Drone brood can be stored in a freezer and consumed with honey or used to make a medicine tincture. Beekeepers usually eat simple food which they prepare themselves twice a day, morning and evening, do not snack between meals and also avoid alcohol because bees cannot stand strong odors and the smell of alcohol fumes in particular. And there is no time for snacks and tea during the daytime. Beekeepers regularly consume small amounts of honey and bee bread, that is a pollen collected by bees, fermented and stored in combs. The fermented pollen contains a large amount of biologically active substances. So this is just a few days ago I separated my box with honey and harvested the honey. So this is how it works. If you will watch my old videos, you see that I use such simple boxes. I have no frames and harvesting of the honey a little bit different. But the advantage that Asian bees, they do not stay in frames. They are very special. So, and then they build the combs and I separate the box with combs and harvest the honey. And this box takes me, to build this box, it takes me a little bit, I would say maybe $2 American for materials, or less actually. This is the upper side of the box. I use this metal plates that bees can connect the combs to the plates. And then after removing the plates, this is the view. And then what I'm doing with a long knife, I just cut one by one the combs and put them into plastic containers like this. So, and Asian bees are different. They do not collect too much honey. It is like from European bees, it is not quite common to get up to 50 kilo of honey for a season. The Asian bees are not so productive, the colonies are smaller, and maybe 10 kilo it would be a good estimation what I can get from one beehive. But honey is very expensive in Taiwan, and especially if it is in combs, then it can be profitable business. Propolis or bee glue is a resinous mixture that honeybees produce by mixing saliva and beeswax and with resin harvested from the buds of trees and other plants. It can be demonstrated, it was demonstrated that the propolis have antifungal fungal and antibacterial properties. Propolis contains a large amount of quercetin. Quercetin is a natural senolytic medicine that kills zombie cells and extending our lifetime. So it is quite well researched, and it is not toxic. So you can use this propolis to extend your life. And reducing the number of zombie cells, as you know, helps to slow down and even reverse the aging of our body. Many beekeepers collect propolis for sale and own use as an alcoholic tincture. A few drops of such tincture may be added to water, and the resulting emulsion is to swallow to prevent colds, as well as to improve general health if it is taken on a regular basis. So these are some publications. I just give a reference in presentation. You can get the reference. And this is a photo of the article, a textual preprint, that propolis is very helpful for to prevent COVID and other viral infections. Then bees sting beekeepers while they are inspecting beehives and collecting honey. Over time, beekeepers develop an immunity to bee venom and tolerate it easily. Actually, bee venom is an excellent medicine that has an excellent effect on enhancing immunity and prolonging life. I believe that it is a real fountain of use, and I will tell about it a little bit more further. Recently, the preparation of bee shilajit became popular. Please watch my older video about this. And according to clinical data, this drug tincture from the bee shilajit is able to heal tuberculosis cavities in the lungs, heal scars, in particular myocardial scars, lower blood pressure, and improve cerebral circulation. Ointments and masks based on the bee shilajit are smoothing wrinkles, increasing elasticity, improving blood circulation and color of skin. This I use, I produce it regular in such tanks. So I mix it about 2 volumes of alcohol, good quality alcohol, and one part of the this bee shilajit, and it stays from time to time. I have to mix it again, and then it stays, it sediments, and then I can consume this tincture. But if you will do it yourself, please mind that it lowers blood pressure, so better to take it before bedtime, not at morning. And be modest, because if you consume too much, it probably can have some side effects. But okay, I mean, as I said, if it is like teaspoon per night before bedtime, it only helps to sleep better. And personally, I have very good experience that it is healing. It is really healing the heart. And if you have some problems with the heart, it calms you down, and all the pain and something, it just disappear. According to information from the site, it's a Russian site, but the extract from the larva of the wax moss or the products of their activity, it is actually poop, such powder, black powder, has a positive effect in the treatment of many diseases, as well as in the rejuvenation of the body. Like some beekeepers, I breed wax moss and larva myself, wax moss larva myself, and to make this bee shilajit tincture, and take the tincture regularly myself. Again, I produce probably too much, because now I have idea maybe to produce some ointment or remedy to rejuvenate skin. I just have to try on myself and to get the composition, but I think it works. And again, people use it for wrinkles, to rejuvenate skin, so it definitely works, because it is breaking this glucoproteins in skin and recover, and also it probably works as a senolytic drug. So beekeepers have the lowest cancer rate of any occupation in the world. The telomeres in beekeepers were found to be significantly longer than in non-beekeepers, suggesting that beekeepers should have fewer zombie cells, while propolis and some other beekeeping products, such as bee venom, act as senolytics, and probably this bee shielded. Hippocrates used bee venom to treat joint pain and arthritis. Honeybee venom has shown great potential in other medical treatments such as eczema, and has been known for some time to have anti-tumor properties, including melanoma, skin cancer. So this was published, and quite many publications on it. This is a publication with a literature review on year 2019. And I make some quotes from these publications, like, many experimental and clinical reports show that bee venom has anti-inflammatory, anti-apoptotic, anti-fibrotic, and antibacterial, antiviral, antifungal, and anti-tumor effect. In particular, the following was demonstrated in clinical trials, that bee venom has the potential to be used to treat hair loss, as it can stimulate hair growth. Indeed, the baldness can be attributed to the accumulation of zombie cells. I will talk about this later. And the use of senolytics allows you to fight baldness and even grain of hair. Please, I give this reference. You can read it yourself. And psoriasis, for example, the result of bee venom injections demonstrated complete recovery in 23 of 25 patients. Skin wrinkles. Serum and ointments containing bee venom reduce the average depth of wrinkles, the total area of wrinkles, and their number. They rejuvenate the skin. Indeed, as I said, zombie cells accumulate in aging skin and can contribute to age-related changes and skin pathologies. I give the reference about this research dated 2018. So you see at this picture that mostly the senescent cells in skin, this is melanocytes. This is the cells which produce melanin. It makes our skin brown or dark, and it protects us from UV, ultraviolet, but maybe because of the ultraviolet, somehow it is especially these melanocytes are very, very sensitive to get zombie cells, and they produce a lot of the signaling molecules, SASP. I was talking about this already. And when they produce this SASP signal molecules, they, let's say, infect the other cells, and these cells do not function properly. Okay, then also venom, skin wounds. Topical application of bee venom can be very beneficial in reducing the size of wounds and healing them quickly. Acne. Cosmetics containing bee venom have shown a noticeable therapeutic effect in reducing acne. No serious side effects were reported in the studies reviewed. There is a possibility that the combination of bee venom and conventional medicine can minimize the side effects of conventional medicine. Okay, this was such publication. You can see. And bee venom has been widely used to treat several immune-related diseases, and more recently to treat cancerous tumors. Recent studies have reported the induction of death and necrosis and growth inhibition of various types of cancer cells in vivo and vitro. Components of bee venom and melitene about that has only about 50-70% of dry weight of the venom. The upper pine, upper mine, and other components. So, and the bees produce melitene not only in their venom, but also in other tissues where it is produced in response to infections. So, it is very potent substance. Melitene can completely destroy cancer cells membranes within 60 minutes. And bee venom may also destroy zombie cells, which like cancerous cells are hyperactive in protein synthesis. This is my idea that it is not yet investigated, but I think the gain that if we apply bee venom or that can be stung by bees, then can help us to rejuvenate skin. It's again at the, here you see picture of the epidermis. You see this melanocytes, and they get infected and they get senolytic, they get zombie, and they produce the signal molecules and like turn the other living cells which should multiply, they turn them again to the zombie cells. So it is not produced enough of the skin, and the thickness of the skin is gets thinner, I mean reduced. So at the same time, melanin has little effect on normal cells, especially on living cells of the epidermis. Bee venom smooths the skin better than Botox injections. So here again the model how the senolytics can help to rejuvenate our skin. So in the normal young skin, these melanocytes, they are healthy, they just produce melanin in response to ultraviolet radiation, and we have all good function in the skin, and some cells produce this elastin and to keep our skin elastic. And then, but if the melanocytes get zombie, get senescent, they do not function properly. They not only stop protect us from UV, but they also poison all the cells nearby, including the stem cells. And then our skin is not working properly, so we don't have enough of this elastin and collagen produced. So we have this very old type of the skin. So we have to, the idea is to rejuvenate skin by killing senescent cells. And bee venom is a good candidate for this, and probably bee sewage can help also. At least it should be tried. I think it is good idea. It has been demonstrated that melitene is a potent inhibitor of the growth of cancer and also zombie cells, and can induce apoptotic death of both cancer and zombie cells. The direct senolytic necrotic effect of melitene on cancer cells of various types of cancer has been reported. Again, this was demonstrated. And bee venom increases the amount of hemoglobin, reduces the viscosity and coagulability of blood, reduces the amount of cholesterol in the blood, increases the withdrawal of fluid from the body, dilates blood vessels, increases blood flow to the diseased organ, relieves pain, increases overall tone, and the performance, and improves health and appetite, restore potency in older men. This is no there is no better remedy for sciatica than bee venom. It is 100 times more anesthetic than morphine. Bee venom has a strong antibacterial effect and successfully copes with the causative agent of tuberculosis, D. diphtheria and streptococci and other diseases. In medical industry, there is a whole direction, apitherapy, the basis of which is the treatment and prevention diseases with help of bee stinging. The number of articles devoted to the medical properties of the bee venom exceeds many hundreds, both in Russian and English. Russian and English. I have collected and present below some links to publications, the text of which is fully published in the public domain on the internet. So just to give you this photo, and you can Google it yourself and to see the medical medical effect of the bee venom and other bee products. And however, the use of bee venom as synolytic medicine has not yet been proven. I believe that along with propolis, which has quercetin, this already synolytic, which is proven, bee venom can reduce the number of zombie cells in our body, especially in skin, significantly rejuvenate and prolong the life of people. As for beekeepers, collecting bee venom, bee sewage and other beekeeping products will be additional source of income along with selling of honey. I would say so, that now it is so difficult to buy real honey, real organic honey. Mostly in supermarkets, they sell just inverted sucrose, no, inverted sugar. And this has no positive effect and only give us overload us with fructose, and fructose is not so good. But these products, what I was telling about, this, for example, Shivajit, this the tincture of the Shivajit is very, very helpful. It is yet to discover further positive effects, because normally people would take it orally, but some people use it for skin rejuvenation. So it has to be, this direction probably has to be developed further. I personally made this insect farm in my farmhouse and have such bottles like this regular, like 6-8 bottles, 2-liter bottles. And then all this with this tincture. And problem again that people are not aware much this remedy. In Russia and Ukraine it is very popular and quite expensive, but in other countries yet not. So it is, well, again, question how to show the people that it is very, very useful. Okay, this video I made for educational and informational purposes only. It may contain copyrighted materials, the use of which has not been authorized by the copyright owner. Okay, I mean, I always try to make a reference to the source, but okay, I never was asking. But as I have no profit from this, as I'm not getting any financial profit from the video, and then I don't throw away the patent law. And okay, and please thank you if you have time. If you take time to watch the video to the end, please comment, subscribe, like, ask questions and share information. I would say we live in very difficult times, and it is very, very important to keep your body healthy, because we have real genocide of all the people, and all these lockdowns, and the older people have to stay indoors and have very limited physical activity. It is actually genocide, because your health is going down. So to my opinion, again, what I did years before, that I started this beekeeping. Beekeeping is a very good hobby. It is also, it gives you additional income. But more than this, you have some reasonable activity and then you consume these bee products, and you extend your life, you improve your health. dramatically. So again, stay away from big cities, stay away, don't stay away from these lockdowns. If you want to live longer, please think about this to produce. And then again, beekeeping, it does not need much space. It is not like farming. You don't need hundreds of acres or thousands of acres to grow anything. It can be in your garden, near your house, and to keep 5, 10, and here I was keeping 30 beehives, and it is enough. It gives some income, and again, it is such a fun to take care of bees. So, and of course, professional beekeepers are getting much more money, and they keep up to 1,000 beehives, and it is all they're moving all time from one place to another, so it is a little bit maybe more complicated, because if everybody cannot get a beekeeper, but for your hobby, for if you have time, spare time during your retirement, it's very, very good activity, very good activity, and I recommend it. So okay, have a wonderful day. See you next time in my videos.